So, that was a documentary, right? Okay, not exactly, but here's what we got today. Woolly mammoths, elephants, or like, they're, Harvard's combining them. It's science. African elephants are going extinct in as little as 2 years. Now, unfortunately, that's probably not a shocker. Humans have a tendency to cause extinctions with all the ways we're aggravating climate change. But in a move that resembles Jurassic Park more than actual science, a group of researchers at Harvard University, spearheaded by world-renowned geneticist Dr. George Church, are working on a way of preventing the extinction of elephants and potentially lessening climate change by melding Asian elephant DNA with that of the woolly mammoth. And that is exactly as insane as it sounds. But the research has been going on for 11 years, and it seems promising. Now, the easiest way to envision it is to think of it like a video game. Let's call your character Ed, the elephant. He has three major weaknesses. Weakness number one, Ed gets hounded by poachers wanting his tusks. Church's experiment plans to make him less attractive to poachers by genetically engineering smaller or even non-existent tusks. Weakness number two, Ed is a delicate desert flower. Without at least a cardigan, he suffers from climate swings that kill both him and his habitat. This experiment could genetically modify Ed to have shaggier hair or even antifreeze blood. That way, Ed could roam and settle down in more places than he does now. And he could survive through the bitter cold winters. Weakness number three. Ed and all the other elephants haven't exactly been getting jiggy with it, if you know what I mean. Now, that means that baby Eds have no genetic variety. And if the environment changes faster than his lineage can evolve, all the baby elephants are out of luck. And also dead. They're gonna be very, very dead. So to save Ed and the rest of the elephants, scientists are resurrecting 44 woolly mammoth genes captured from a frozen mammoth carcass preserved in an Arctic permafrost, which is arguably the coolest sentence I've said all day. And with that, they aim to do something similar to the lamb in the artificial womb that we saw last year, but on a much larger scale, and arguably with a much, much bigger bag. And why in a bag? Well, this is still far too experimental to be safe for a mama elephant, but these genetic modifications will, of course, come with the cost. Resurrecting old species might damage the environment more than we already have, and we don't really know what the repercussions will be. Will the final product be the animal we actually want? Do we have the resources to manage its survival as a new endangered species? Who foots the bill and who maintains their evolution? Furthermore, if we do save the elephants by hybridizing them, are we still basically killing them? Because this will be an entirely new species. And if the new hybrid elephants are the only ones who survive, the old elephants are still gone. Can man save Ed from our own damaging habits? Or better yet, should he? In terms of pushing the boundaries of science, we as humans have caused so much damage to the species, we should at least try to repair some of that. And at the very least, this is the next iteration in science fiction becoming a reality.